Hey everybody, welcome back to How to Thaumcraft with the Hittite. Today we're talking about opening the eye and the outer lands. It's kind of the end game for Thaumcraft, but not really if you have Thaumic Tinkerer installed. Anyway, the first thing you're going to need is the Crimson Rites. It's a book that's a rare drop from the Crimson Cultists that are found around these obelisks. I've mentioned them before, but again, it's a rare drop, so you're probably going to have to search for a while to get it. It's taken me several hours to find it before, just wandering around. Now, if you read it, not much happens. An entry opens up in the Thaumonomicon here. But, hold on. Lag. A little bit of lag. There we go. But, not much happens. Unless, of course, you have your sanity meter all the way full. If you fill it all the way up to the top, the little brain that's at the top will crack. And that's what lets you know that you're in the special magical madness place. In which case, reading the Crimson Rites will open up this research right here. Opening the eye. For that, you need to make 4 Eldritch Eyes. For that, you need 4 Eyes of Ender, which is Ender Pearl plus Blaze Powder. But Eye of Ender infused with a gold ingot and void seed with a whole lot of Essentia. The 4 Eldritch Eyes go here on the Arcane on the Eldritch Altar, not the Arcane Pedestal, that's a different thing. Right here. And you're going to need to be careful because once the eyes are on the altar, it's going to spawn a pretty steady stream of Eldritch Guardians. Hello. There it goes. Well, usually it does. Anyway, it's more likely to. Seriously? Can you get the music, please? It's really loud. Okay. Then, once that's done, take a wand and put at least 100 of each type of this right into the center. Lag? Nyom. Black hole. Alright, before we jump in, let's go over some of our equipment here. First, I've got 2 staves. Backed up with that. A bunch of scepters in my inventory to power all of my stuff. I've got a Sword of the Zephyr and Bow of Bone. I didn't talk about those before, but they're here in the Artifice tab. Sword of the Zephyr. It's got the same base damage as a diamond sword, but when you hit it, it'll hit all nearby enemies. Hit an enemy with it, and it'll hit all nearby enemies. And if you block with it, it creates an air shield. The Bow of Bone is up here. It's a little faster and stronger than a normal bow, and interestingly enough, if you enchant it with infinity, you don't even need any arrows. It just creates them out of thin air. Keeping those along because there's one boss that's kind of immune to all of the wand foci. Anyway, I'm also bringing along redstone repeaters because it's a way for me to mark my way that has a built-in arrow to point back towards the beginning. But enough about that. Jumping in. We appear in a maze of twisty passages, all the same. This is the Outer Lands. And just a heads up, do not touch the Starry Void chunks. They will kill you very quickly. But since I'm, in creative mode, I don't actually take damage. Let's talk about some of the stuff we got around here. We've got ancient stone. Which, hey, excavation focus does work on those. Pickaxe doesn't, though. Those are just building blocks that kind of look cool. There's glowing crusted stone, which drops experience when it's broken. These crystals up here drop balanced shards. And one more thing. Glyphed stone drops knowledge fragments. I haven't really talked about them, but if you get 9 of them together, you can make one. You can make a research that you might not have unlocked yet. It's a good way to double check that you've got the right research going. Again, careful which blocks you break, because outside of this is just void and it'll kill you very quickly. And let's go exploring. Here's some enemies. They're fun. Eldritch crabs. Ooh, that's a champion Eldritch crab. Let's use lightning on him. They're the common enemies. Those little vents in the side are crusted openings. They'll crap out Eldritch crabs at a pretty steady rate. I think they eventually go away, but not really. Other than the crabs, there's Eldritch guardians around here too. Only you might notice they're a bit more solid than they are in the overworld. They've also got a runic shield on them. Not any stronger than normal, but the runic shield gives them effectively about 20 more HP. Makes it a lot harder to fight them. Ah, here we go. You'll get some of these intersections filled with crusted stone. Again, careful which blocks you break, because you do not want to fall out. See? Here we go. Shambling husk. Basically a zombie, but when it dies, it turns into an Eldritch crab that got stuck in the wall. Ooh. That's something to be careful of. That is runed stone. Yeah, see those runes appearing in the air? It's gonna start shooting lightning at me if I stay close. Wait for it. Meh. Take some for the collection. Oh yeah, there's a... There's treasure pots around here. Random treasure in it. Like this one is Splash Potion of Water Breathing. Not really useful to me, but... Or here, but... Oh, and Journey Map is basically worthless. Since it's all indoors, it can't really show you anything. Here's one of the rooms that are available. just filled with a whole bunch of glyphed stone. So if you want a whole bunch of knowledge fragments, this is where you go. Oh yeah, that rune stone is shooting lightning at me. And it'll give me warp if I stayed around it too close. And this hallway's full of taint. It happens. Oh, well, what do you know? Wasn't expecting to find it so fast. Hold on a second, that Eldritch Guardian is in the way. This is the first room we're looking for, the key room. What we want here is the rune tablet, because that's the key to the boss room. It might be worth it to explore this whole area and for all the treasure you can get, because you can get a lot of treasure, but what you're really here for is the boss. Yep, dead end. Well, I'm just wandering around. I should probably mention that you probably don't want to come here unless you've got a friend with you. I already went this way. And if you don't have a friend, bring some golems or something, or, here in the golemancy tab, I didn't really talk about them much, but the traveling trunk. It's basically a hungry chest that's been infused with a wood golem. And it's a chest that'll follow you around, and that tentacle was not there before. But it's a trunk that'll follow you around and can be used for extra inventory. You can also put upgrades on it. Yeah, here's a new room. Like, if you put a fire upgrade on the chest, it'll actually protect you and fight any enemies that are nearby. Otherwise, it just follows you around and is kind of annoying. This room, as you can see, is absolutely full of Eldritch crabs, but it's also full of treasure pots. So, there's that.
I saw my baby crying for the space. What kind of magic spell to use? Spell. Oh, what we don't tell. Thunder, wind, and babies.
Wait. Is that? It is. There's the doorway. I didn't even. Whew, that's freaky. Never noticed the way it pulsates before. Hold on, I'm gonna check around this corner and see if I can find a mine spider nest anywhere. 'Cause I didn't get to show those off. Nope. Weren't any mine spiders in this. Okay. Oh, neat. I got deadly gaze. That makes anyone I look at have wither. Wonder if that works on mobs too. It does! It does! I gave that shambling husk wither by looking at it. That's the best warp effect to have in this area. Easily. Anyway, mind spiders. They're itty-bitty spiders, only have half a heart each, so they're easy to kill, but they're hard to see because they're mostly transparent, and there's places where there's a spawner right in the middle of the hall and it's completely surrounded by spider webs. Very annoying. But anyway, let's go face this boss. Wonder what we get. Oh. Ooh. It's a boss Eldritch Guardian. I'm in creative mode, so it's not going to hurt me, but actually, you know what? No, I'm not gonna fight this normally, because I have a feeling it would kick my butt. Yeah, that lightning on the ground will hurt you and slow you down. Yay. See that right there? That's what we came here to get. The primordial pearl. Pretty neat. Lightning all over the ground. Gonna be there a while. Anyway. Maybe that guy wouldn't have owned me that badly. Anyway. That's it. That's what we're here for. Now, once you've beaten the Outer Lands and beaten the boss and explored everything you want to, there's revelations in the Outer Lands, which and also Outer Lands observations, but anyway, that's mostly just there for, I guess, flavor for world building. What you're really here for is the Primordial Pearl. It's a big knot of raw primal energy, and it's useful for making stuff. Heh. Heh. Heh, okay. Okay. Back to the overworld it is. Alright, you can do all sorts of things with that primordial pearl. But it's mostly a couple of them. One, advanced alchemical furnace. One that doesn't need fuel and only cinnabis to work. I might set that up and show you how it works in a little bit, but for right now, it's pretty cool. Two, the Primal Crusher. It's a pickaxe and a shovel all in one. But also it does a lot of damage and it's kind of cool. But It's okay. And also, you can use a primordial pearl on a node, and it might improve it, maybe. Or it could do something else. I don't know. It'll do something. And that's it. That's the Outer Lands. I'm gonna go shut up the set up the that advanced alchemical furnace. Okay, so for the advanced furnace, you need 8 advanced alchemical constructs. That's a primordial pearl in the middle with 4 alchemical constructs and void metal. Just a quick note, the primordial pearl does not get used up when you make this, so you can make as many of those as you want. But anyway, you set up 8 of them in a block. In the center, you have a normal alchemical furnace, then 4 normal constructs, like so, and alembics at the corners. Then you get a wand, and you tap it. It needs a constant influx of fire cindervis from an energized node to keep going. Usually 10 will give it full power, and you can tell how full power it's going with that. It also needs water and entropy to break stuff down. Now then, you can't access it directly. You can pipe it out through those ports in the sides, and I'm going to use a reservoir for that. And just to show you how quick this works, let's grab some beacons. Where are those? Beacons have a lot of essentia, and I'm going to be dumping an entire stack in. Yeah, probably don't want to stand in it. And it's gone. Look at it go. Think I need more reservoirs. And some golems, probably. Hold on a second. Luckily, alchemy golems can take from essential reservoirs that are full. Attach it directly to this. Set up a whole buttload of jars. Animate this sucker and attach him to a jar. You can, of course, put multiple reservoirs or even a pipe system or something. Look how quickly he goes. And there's a lot more you can do with this. This is just a demonstration. Anyway, I hope that didn't drag on too long, and I hope you enjoyed watching me stumble around in a labyrinth in the Outer Lands, and I hope you check out Thaumcraft. It's a fun add-on if you want to play it. Anyway, thank you all for watching, and I've still got a few more things to show off in Thaumcraft before I'm done. And so I'll catch you next time.